world is changing. The planet's heating up. What the fuck is going on? Rearranging. It's like everything happened all at once. What the fuck is going on? The people rising in the streets. The war, the drought. The more I look, the more I see nothing to joke about. Is comedy over? Should I leave you alone? Cause really, who's gonna go for joking at a time like this? Should I be joking at a time like this? I wanna help to leave this world better than I found it. And I fear that comedy won't help, and the fear is not unfounded.
And they won't ever tell you, but they hate to see you make it. And as soon as you get something for yourself, they wanna take it. Well, go on, you can have it. I'll look away while you grab it. Boy, I don't need no stacks and I don't need no baller status. Ain't no power in the dollar, but the power's in the people. Cause our wallets ain't the same, don't mean we ain't created equal. I don't need for you to clap, I don't need for you to cheer. I just hope that when I speak that there's somebody there to hear.
I wanna show you how I'm growing as a person, but first I feel I must address the lyrics from the previous verse. I tried to hide behind my childhood, and that's not okay. My actions are my own, I won't explain them away. And I've been totally awful. My closet is chock full of stuff that is vaguely shitty. All of it was perfectly lawful, just not very thoughtful at all. And just really, and I'm really fucking sorry. So long, goodbye. Do I really have to finish? Do returns always diminish? Did I say that right? Does anybody want to joke when no one's laughing in the background? So this is how it ends. I promise to never go outside again. Am I going crazy? What I even know? Am I right back where I started 14 years ago? Wanna guess the ending, if it ever does. I swear to God that all I've ever wanted was a little bit of everything, all of the time. A bit of everything, all of the time. Apathy's a tragedy and boredom is a crime. I'm finished playing and I'm staying inside. I can sit here and pretend like my biggest problems are Pringle cans and burritos. The truth is my biggest problem's you. I wanna please you, but I wanna stay true to myself. I wanna give you the night out that you deserve, but I wanna say what I think and not care what you think about it. A part of me loves you, part of me hates you, part of me needs you, part of me fears you. And I don't think that I can handle this right now. Handle this right now. I don't think that I can handle this right now. I don't think that I can handle this right now. I don't think that I can handle this right now.
I don't think that I can handle this right now.
Look at them, they're just staring at me like, come and watch the skinny kid with a steadily declining mental health. And laugh as he attempts to give you what he cannot give himself.
I don't think that I can handle this right now. I don't think that I can handle this right now. But they don't even know the half of this right now.
But they don't even know the half of it. But I know I'm not a doctor, I'm a pussy, I put on a silly show. I should probably just shut up and do my job, so here I go.
I'm a special kind of white guy. I self-reflected and I wanna be an agent of change. So I am gonna use my privilege for the good. And I wanna help to leave this world better than I found it. And I fear that comedy won't help, and the fear is not unfounded. I know what I gotta do.
We're at the end of 2022, if you can believe that. It's been nearly a year since I brought back the Cinematic Venom channel and brand, and there was never really an explanation to you guys about deleting it. I feel like that was unfair and that you're definitely overdue one. I've been doing videos since I was 15 years old, and it started as my escape because I didn't have friends and I got bullied. It was a distraction. And that formed this obsession with the internet. But it also helped me find something that, in my opinion, is the only thing I'm actually good at. And with that led to an incredibly strong passion and obsession. But when I started, people didn't watch me. So I could say and do whatever I wanted. I was young and I didn't really give a shit. Naturally, in 2019, I do the initial video, the Channel Awesome documentary, and it blows up way more than I ever expected. Going from having no viewers to hundreds of thousands coming onto the internet, and at first agreeing with me and praising me, there was so much pressure, but also added frustration. I was trying to help a particular movement that didn't really reciprocate the admiration that I had for them at the time, and it went down south. So I had this huge surge of viewers, and then it was seemingly taken away from me by my own actions. It's no one's fault but my own, but that messed with my head to go from having hundreds of thousands of people telling me how great I was to then suddenly hating me. That really took a huge blow to my mental health. You can't put videos on the internet without the expectation of receiving criticism and hate. It's going to happen. But at the time, I really, really struggled with it. I was trying to do the right thing. After that, I tried desperately to repair the channel, but it was so frustrating, and I took it out on you guys. There's some of you who have been watching me for over 10 years, which is incredible, and I could never thank you enough for that. The frustration grew, and I had anger and resentment towards you people. It was my own brain and my own illogical thinking. I was trying to do what made me happy, but then also try to make you happy. But it seemed to be impossible to do both. You know, I wanted to make comedy videos, but no one was interested. They just wanted movie reviews. Then the channel blew up with the Channel Awesome stuff. People only wanted drama. I tried bringing back movie reviews and nobody cared. After the Channel Awesome stuff died down, I fell into complete obscurity and irrelevancy. My 15 minutes of fame were over, and was it worth it? I attempted to defame this massive company, which my stance on that whole movement has drastically changed. And because of my actions back then, it's now severed like any possibilities of working with certain people, which in turn damages a lot of possible opportunities on YouTube in general. EFAP then covered the Lord of the Rings video. I always felt like I was untouchable because I didn't have many viewers, so I didn't have people to say, hey, this was wrong, hey, this was bad. So I just kept making content and I didn't have that feedback to say, work on this. To have hundreds of thousands of people roast me, turn me into a meme, I thought it was all malicious, just for the sake of a video. And again, it really damaged my mental health. It was my own actions and me not being able to handle taking responsibility for them. You can't make a review as bad as that and then expect people to not take the piss out of it. Months go by and I realized this just wasn't for me. Cinematic Venom wasn't for me anymore. I wasn't enjoying it. Every other week, people were coming out to try and cancel me. I'm not a victim and I can defend myself when needed, but a lot of these were unjustified. And even if I've been a prick, which I have a lot, it's not justified to call me things like an abuser, which I'm not. It's not justified to try to ruin my entire career because of things that make me a bit of a dick, but not an abuser. People were coming out of the woodworks and I just thought, fuck it. A lot of it was my own actions in the past. Racist things I've said, defending those racist things, trying to justify homophobic or transphobic things. My awful actions that I was constantly trying to defend rather than just make amends for. And I realized I'm done. If somebody wanted to work with me, all they would have to do is Google Cinematic Venom. And at that point, all that would come up is the racist stuff, the homophobic stuff, the transphobic stuff, all the things that I'm not, and all the things that are in the past and stupid actions I did that I deeply regret. I realized there's no going back from this. There's no recovering from this. The Channel Awesome stuff, I said stuff to certain people that they can never forgive me over, which I completely understand. There's people involved in that that are no longer with us that I wish I could have made amends with beforehand and now unable to. It's all these awful actions that with someone who has depression and anxiety, you overthink them and you replay them in your head day after day after day. Instead of you need to learn to let it go. There's nothing you can do. It is done. It is in the past. But in that same respect, I was just constantly apologizing to people. There are people that I've done wrong, people I don't talk to anymore, people who I've reached out to privately. But because I haven't done it publicly, people think I'm in the wrong. Not everything needs to be content, and I need to realize that now, because there have been many times where I wanted to reach out to someone in a public forum and make it this big thing and maybe make a huge song and music video. And I'm like, no, these are real people. Real lives. Do it privately. If they don't want to make amends, drop it. That's what it took me a while to realize. Just saying sorry doesn't make it okay. They don't have to forgive you. Say you're sorry and move on. I feel like me apologizing has just been a constant on YouTube. Just say it and then move on. I tried to rebrand the channel. I changed my name. It's now my partner's name. Because my name has just been tainted, as well as certain issues with my biological family that I really want to get away from. And I tried making a channel with vlogs, gaming, just anything else, and it didn't really work. We get to 2021, I was beyond irrelevant. I still had the Cinematic Venom channel. I was posting videos on it, but they weren't reviews. I was trying desperately to rebrand. And then I started to redeem myself. I was on podcasts with EFAP Associates. And I have to say, considering I felt like EFAP were bullying and targeting and harassing me, their fan base is actually one of the most wholesome I have encountered. They have genuinely been so nice and so supportive. I'm in Mauler's Discord, I'm on their Reddit, and the fans are so nice. And the guys, I was on Southpaw's podcast, and they were just so friendly. People were warming to me again. Mauler did actually invite me onto EFAP, but I was going through hell with some things that I'd found out about my family, and I ignored him. By the time I did reply, I'm guessing it just got lost. I came back with that one Lord of the Rings review, and everyone thought I was back doing monthly reviews, and then randomly I just closed the channel. It felt like nothing I could do could save or salvage my own past. My obsession with the past has always been my downfall, and that's the fucking problem. My biggest problem as well is realize that nobody cares. Not in a negative way. That's the thing with anxiety and depression. You think, oh, no one cares, but you need to change that mindset to think, no one cares. When you're anxious, you're like, I can't go there, they're going to make fun of me. But in reality, they don't give a fuck. They're not going to make fun of you because they don't care. They've got their own stuff going on. I would make these big budget, or to me, big budget videos and try to incorporate my own life when in actuality, no one really gave a shit. I would get very, very frustrated because people either weren't following the storyline in Venomoth. They weren't following the storyline in my videos. They weren't really following what I was doing. But then say that they would watch every video. It was just very frustrating, and I started to grow a disdain for my own audience. And I felt I couldn't do it anymore. People said he's obviously going to bring Cinematic Venom back. That's why he kept the channel open. I guess this was a way to stick it to him, and I deleted the channel. And I probably shouldn't have. How am I doing now? I still have down days. We're in 2022. Why did I reboot the channel? I'll tell you why. Early this year, on Seeking Answers, which if you've still followed me on that channel, thank you so much. We were doing some re-edits of old episodes and posting weekly. And that would give us time to keep posting weekly. It gave me the idea that if I did that with Cinematic Venom, I have such a back catalogue that I could theoretically not do anything. I could just re-edit them slightly and then schedule them all. And I wouldn't do anything for about 3 or 4 years. You know, I wasn't happy with the person I was. I wasn't happy with the person I am. And I thought, well, by the time these videos are all up, maybe I will be a better person and a person I'm proud of. And then I'll be ready to rejoin the internet. So that was the original idea, and I started re-editing and scheduling them. But then I got to the Jumanji videos, and I realized, well, I'd actually written a review of Zathura. And Bradley Pierce was supposed to be in it, actually reviewing it with me, but he got too busy. So I just had this script lying around. So I went and recorded it, and I changed the reviewing style and the editing style and everything to make them a lot shorter. And from that, it just got onto me reviewing entire franchises. And I fell back in love with movie reviews. I started a new job. I'm finally out of retail. I now am a key account administrator for a logistics company. I'm a lot happier there. And the money's better. Seeking Answers is doing great. And Cinematic Venom, I was posting old episodes, new episodes. People still aren't sure if this channel is me, even though there's a bunch of new episodes on here. Venomoth, Venom on the Shelf, all great. As I'm recording this, Venom on the Shelf hasn't even started yet. I'm filming everything so far in advance. I got engaged this year. Can you believe it? I'm all grown up. It's been a much better year for me. People are starting to realize that I'm back. So the support has been unreal. I'm sorry that my head got too far up my own ass, and I kind of lost sight of what was important. I took it out on you guys. I had this frustration with you guys, but it was my own head putting ridiculous amounts of pressure on myself. It wasn't your guys' fault. I had this huge expectation that I set. And now we're at the end of the year, looking back. Views aren't great. It's going to take some time to rebuild the channel. I'm going to put the stats on the screen. This is what we are at the time of me editing this, which again is way in advance. They might be hugely shot up or down by the time you see this. And earlier in the year, I hyped it and mentioned it on the old Cinematic Venom channel, but my documentary on me running the London Marathon finally came out. It's on another channel that I'm going to post my film projects that aren't Cinematic Venom related, so please go and check it out. Really proud of it, worked really hard on it.
The thing is, over time, there was just less and less incentive for Cinematic Venom to continue. Once the Change the Channel fallout happened, I became completely irrelevant. I did the Venom Month of Horrors 4 years in a row. The views never increased. My channel was basically dead. I did Venom Month 4 after the EFAP stuff, and the whole channel was irrelevant. Nobody cared. Meanwhile, on my other channel, views were going up, and Seeking Answers has a much wider demographic. It's a lot more appealing to a much broader audience. So in reality, there's no real reason to continue making Cinematic Venom. Even now that I've brought it back, the views, I mean, I realize it's going to take time, but the views are so low. Logically, I should just focus on the more successful channel and work on growing that. Quite literally, the only reason to continue making Cinematic Venom is quite bluntly because I want to. Cinematic Venom is kind of my outlet. It's where I get to be more of myself, show my personality, have fun, do reactions, curious cats, you know, and add comedy, which I love sharing so much. And without Cinematic Venom, I can't do that on the other channel. So I'm at the point now, I used to obsess on the views, I used to think, well, there's no point in making it, nobody cares. But now I've come to realize, actually, I don't really give a shit if no one else cares, because I care. I've fallen back in love with making these videos, and I'm working so far ahead in advance that I don't really notice when a video drops, so I'm not sat there focused on the viewership. It doesn't matter to me. I can just make the videos because I enjoy making them.
But I'm back now. We're going to do it right this time. 3 videos a week. If you're unfamiliar, there's a new episode of the 1001 Movies You Must See Before You Die every Tuesday, and a Cinematic Venom movie review of anything I fancy every Thursday, and then a comedy video or some kind of extra video every Saturday, 7 p.m. all of those days, UK time. Seeking Answers posts every 2 Sundays at 5 p.m. UK time. I'm back. Thank you all for the support. It's been a hell of a year. To all those affected, one last time, I apologize. If you do want to reach out, you can do it privately. I'm putting this out there, extending the olive branch. I'm not going to bother trying to reach out anymore. I've done that numerous times and just got disappointment. If you want to reach out, please do. There's a good chance I miss you too. Or want to apologize 7 more million times. Thank you all. Take care. Hope you all had a great Christmas and have a great New Year.